What's up, guys? It's that time of year where I'm starting to get the itch to get back into metalworking again. Now, I went on Amazon to order a new clay graphite crucible, but apparently I ordered the wrong one because this thing is absolutely massive and way too big for my mini metal foundry. So I thought today might be a good opportunity to try making a larger metal foundry with a large metal pail and some proper refractory material so it lasts a bit longer. Now you could get a big bag of refractory cement, mix it up, and cast it the same way we did with our plaster and sand mix, but today I wanted to try using kaowool. This stuff is a very flexible ceramic mat, and although it looks really flimsy, really fragile, and looks like it'll go up in flames, it is extremely temperature resistant. In fact, it's so well insulated that if I fire up one of my blow torches and shoot it straight at it, I can hold the other side without feeling any of the heat penetrate into it. So here's the basic idea for today. We're gonna take this metal bucket, we're gonna line it with kaowool, drill a couple of holes so our propane torches can fit down inside it, and then line the top of the pail with insulation so it can sit on top as a cover. The goal of today's experiment is speed, convenience, and a brand new metal foundry that can handle extreme temperatures and thermal shock. Let's get busy. Now I should be wearing a mask doing this, but I'm just gonna cut very slowly, very carefully, and take a risk. Now when dealing with kaowool, there are a couple things you need to know. This stuff is extremely fibrous, and when you start cutting it, it'll put a kaowool dust into the air that's very, very bad for your lungs. If you breathe too much of this stuff in, it can cause long-term damage. So you can see, I used a pair of scissors to cut the kaowool out in a circle about 2 inches in diameter wider than the lid itself. The thinking here is that'll give us a little extra room to cram it down into the lid so it holds into place a bit better. We'll see if that's really the case. It actually looks like that's gonna work. Just gonna pad that down a little bit more, press it into place, and I think we may be in business. There we go. Got the lid all pressed into place, so let's move on to lining the bucket next. So here's what we managed to do so far. We have lined the lid with kaowool, we've lined the bottom and the sides of our steel bucket, and we cut off some more refractory material and shoved it down the bottom to act as a base for our crucible. At this point, all that's left to do is drill some holes. So, let's drill some holes. There we go. Exciting news, guys, our foundry is ready for operation. We've got two holes in the sides that our propane torches can fit into. And you can see I've made these little wooden blocks here with a groove in the middle that are designed to hold the propane torches off the ground and in position. If you look down inside the foundry, you can see the two propane torches come in at opposite angles. And it's designed that way so when we light this thing up, it'll create a swirling hurricane of fire that'll get this thing roaring hot. At this point, we're pretty much ready to start melting down some metals, but there's one thing that we need to do first, and that's to temper our clay graphite crucible. You might remember from a previous video that if we just throw these things in raw and light them up, they have a tendency to break, crack, or explode. And I put way too much money into this crucible to allow that to happen. To make sure we do things right, we need to temper our clay graphite crucible. That means we're gonna put it in the foundry and slowly bring up the temperature over time until we can get it glowing red hot, and then we'll let it cool down on its own. Oh, wow, that looks cool. You know what's cool is you can look down through the vent holes and actually see the crucible as well, so you can tell when it's ready.
I have created fire. Fiery vortex of metal smelting power.
I'm pretty sure this thing will take down copper no problem. So let's recap some of the things we learned here today. We found that you could take any steel container, line it with kaowool, and instantly make a high temperature backyard foundry. We also discovered this stuff is easy to cut and extremely lightweight. This entire contraption weighs less than 10 pounds. We also learned that kaowool is toxic if you breathe it in, so you do want to be wearing a dust mask if you ever try cutting it. And it's extremely itchy if it makes contact with your skin, so it's a good idea to wear long sleeves. That's pretty much it for this project, guys, and I'm very excited to see how well this thing performs in future metal casting experiments. Big shout out to my friend Jerem for donating this kaowool to me for free. I appreciate your donation, Jerem. I've put it to good use. Thanks for joining me for this project. I'll be looking for you in the next one. Talk to you then. It's gonna burn my ceiling. Probably not good that I'm sneezing right now.